Okay, this is part two. Leaving off where I left off at, this is from the Book of the Encounters. And like I said, I'm just explaining how, just showing other facts and scripts that proves that the Negroes are the Israelites and that the angels that are in these ships are, they look just like regular people, which are Israelites. They look like Israelites. Okay, so this says on page 286, eat foods with the highest vibration on your planet. They will nourish you. So this goes into the Levitical laws. You know, not eating pork, not eating shellfish, you know, not eating fruit off the tree the first 4 years. You know, there's a lot of basic knowledge in the five books of Moses, you know, the Torah. I'm going to jump back down to the middle of the book, middle of the page here. Dr. Fiore, how do you do that? How do you know that? Diane, my vibration is not up to theirs. I can't disappear and reappear. Remember we spoke about earlier how Christ was able to appear and reappear? So that's a vibration, you know, the Heavenly Father. It's a gift. So it says, my vibration is not up to theirs. I can't yet disappear and reappear. If you look at the precept I put up, Luke 24 and 31, you might want to look that up on your own, the way they can. He says, talking about the angel, he says, we will all do that eventually. And the more we pray in the light, what's the light? Jesus Christ and keeping the commandments. All right? It says, and the more we pray in the light, this accelerates our vibration. That is the key to our evolution. Is that contact with the Most High who created the universe. You see that? So we're supposed to walk in love and provide the service of charity. I'm going to jump down here. And having love is keeping the commandments. It says here, they say, turn that on and join the light and then help others to awaken their light as well. So when we go out there on the streets and we're pushing the work, you can see those Israelites on corners on Saturdays. That's what they're doing. They're trying to turn on the lights of other elects. All right? We're out there for the elect in the one-third. All right? So down here it says, Dr. Fuhrer, who holds hands? It says, Diane, all the people in the room from all over our area, the Bay Area, they work this area today. And they only come back every so many years, it feels like. But this trip is the biggest one. So let me expound on that. So it says here that these people are going to be in the Bay Area. So it just shows you that the Most High has clusters of people who are going to believe in His laws, statutes, and commandments and the faith of Christ throughout the place of America, which is known in the scriptures as Mystery Babylon. Okay? So we saw 50 people in this particular ship. We know there's other ships. They're going to be in other locations. So if there's 50 people, it don't look like a billion people are going to be in that ship, like the Christian churches teach. Okay? They're only going to be a small remnant. And they're going to be out of the Negroes, Latinos, and American Indians. Right? These are the priests of the Most High, Israel. All right? He's shown His love and His word to Jacob when you read Psalms. All right? 119. We go back over here. It says, I'll start to talk. Every so many years it feels like, but this trip is the biggest one, meaning today, the 2000s. They seem to be concerned about the bombs and the lack of love between countries. And so people have to be stronger in order to little by little raise the vibration of the planet. Okay? So when you see the Israelites out there, what do we always tell you guys? We tell you America's going to be destroyed by nuclear fire. What is the nuclear fire? Those missiles that America has and that Russia has and North Korea has and Japan has. All these small countries have these things. All right? So this is a prophecy. What this woman saw is what we're doing in the streets today. And we've been doing it for the last 30 years or more. Okay? It's just that this is new to most people. So, I'm going to go down, let's see, is there any more that I want to bring out here? Yeah, let me go here. This is talking about how she got there and how she came back. She says, the doctor says, let's see how you got from the ship to your bed. Let yourself remember at the count of five. So she has her under hypnosis. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Diane, I'm standing on this disc. It's a circle about 4 feet by 4 feet. And the ship seems to be very high up in the sky. I mean, I can see the outline of California. I'm so far up. Are you in the ship at this point? I'm in the ship. And we're standing on these discs. And then I feel that numbness again. And I see that bright light again. And then I'm in my bed. Okay, so this is the same way that the prophets got taken up. When you read Ezekiel chapter 8 verse 3, it says that an angel pulled him by his lock and took him up into the spirit world. All right. You look at the verse we brought out earlier in Acts chapter 1, around the 9th verse, it says that Christ was taken up on a cloud and everyone could see him. So that would be like a disc or a chariot. Okay. So just keep that in mind, that people have been talking about who the Israelites are for years. And there's also been visions of the Israelites by other people. Let me go down. Let me bring out one more thing, and I'm going to call it quits on this. It says, this is page 288. It says here, Dr. Fiore, okay, approximately how many people were in the room where you were all together? Diane, in the room where we were holding hands, there seemed to be about 50 or 60 people. Dr. Fiore, did you recognize anyone? Diane, no, and there was, in that corridor, a lot of black people all together. Okay. Were these same black people together in the room where you were all holding hands? Diane, yes, they were there. And when I looked at them, they were the most beautiful people. Their eyes were so beautiful and they seemed so wise. They were evidently in more distressed areas of our area, like Oakland, Fillmore, Hunters Point, you know, Richmond, parts of Sacramento, you know, bad areas. Since they were evidently mainly where the Israelites dwell, most of the Negroes are, you know, the poor. They were evidently in more distressed areas of our area, and they were working with people who had really gotten out of balance. They were very religious and very filled with such joy in the face of what seemed to be a lot of obstacles to overcome. So I felt very good where they were. They were beautiful spirits and they needed a lot of extra encouragement. All right. So just keep that in mind. This is why we're out here. When you see Israelites out there on the streets speaking, it's a spiritual thing, okay? Everybody ain't meant to get this truth. There's only a few that's going to get it. All right. So if you can't understand what this video is about, then hey, and move on. But those of you who understand, now you know why. This is just more proof. These are chariots seen in California. This one looks like a ring. This one's in London. That's a helicopter. The chariot's right above it. So with that, Israel, hopefully that was some good information for you to see that the angels are black. They look just like the Israelites. And that we're going to be redeemed soon. All right. Keep your head looking up. Continue to do the work, believe, keep the commandments of the Most High to the best of your ability.